To say that my life has been normal would be blatant and all out lying. When I first got here, I was roughly around 340 pounds. And to be honest with you, the first day I was here for practice, I passed out on how I was going to feel. I remember walking up this walkway into Gala Center, and a man by the name of Ed Orgeron was behind me yelling at me, telling me that, you know, to push through it, push through it. And as much flack as Ed Orgeron gets, he is really the reason why I'm here today. So I would like to thank Coach Ed Orgeron for all he did for me and my family and my life. Mimi Butler, Debbie Bernstein, Maggie O'Shawley. People don't realize that after my redshirt freshman year, I was actually kicked out of USC. And here I am. Because of Mimi Butler, Debbie Bernstein, and Maggie O'Shawley, they gave me another opportunity to fulfill my dream. I'd be lying if I said, because Mimi Butler is not more than a friend. Every time I come back, she still has my number 95 jersey in her chair. And I just want to say thank you, Mimi, for all that you've done and been to me in my life. You guys, I'd be lying if I told you that when I first got here, I knew I'd be an All-American, I'd be Defensive Player of the Year, or I'd be a first-round draft pick. Things didn't make much sense to me because I was a fan of football. I really did not know left and right when I first got here, I wanted to play football. And the reason why I excelled, and the reason why I kept overcoming things that people never saw in my future, was because of my mom. My mom was a single parent of four. My oldest brother, Thomas, who graduated from the University of St. Thomas, and then went on to graduate from the University of Minnesota Law School. My sister, who is now a teacher, following in the footsteps of my mother in Conyers, Georgia. And my other brother, Etchin, who just graduated from UC Riverside this last spring. I'd be lying if I said my mom didn't show me the meaning of hard work and the appreciation that you get from others by doing your job. And I really hope that I made her proud because everything I've ever done in life was for you. Thank you. February 6, 2008, I had just finished watching the New England Patriots lose to the, anybody know? New York Giants. Come on, we're football fans, right? That's it. After watching that game, I woke up the next morning and I had a really bad case of migraines. Never really had migraines, so when I woke up that morning, I called my cousin and he said, take some motion. I said, okay. So I take Motrin for about 2 or 3 days and I realize that the problem is getting worse. I take myself into the hospital and after about an hour of waiting, I knew something was wrong because when I initially went into the hospital, I was greeted by one doctor. When he came back, there were four doctors. They said, we talked to your team doctor in Minnesota and he said, your white blood cell count back in July when you had your team physical, it was 8,300. Anywhere between 4,000 and 11,000 white blood cells is considered normal. So when I went in that day, they began to tell me that I had a white blood cell count of 279,000. And the reason why I was, you know, developing these migraines was because my blood was starting to become like ooze. He told me that I hate to be the one to tell you this, son, but you have a very aggressive form of leukemia. And I turned off the TV, of course, being the media, I was watching Sports Center. And I raised him a bit and I said, cancer? He said, no, not me. I did everything that I was supposed to do. I worked hard. And I didn't understand. But I promise you, when they told me that I was diagnosed with cancer, I understood it. I never accepted it. I was flown back to Minnesota to undergo treatment at the University of Minnesota. That's where actually the first bone marrow transplant was done. To say that my journey was an easy one, it wasn't. I had many bad days. The saddest thing was watching my mom come and see me in the hospital. And never being able to walk all the way to your car to make sure that you were safe. So I went through the treatment and I went through my chemo. What I'm here to tell you guys is I didn't go to high school prom with a girl that I wanted to, you know, go to prom with. You know, I didn't get drafted where I wanted to be drafted. I went to Minnesota and I had to say I'm from, you know, Los Angeles. What I'm trying to tell you is life is very suddenly gonna go the way you want it to go. But what are you gonna do? Are you going to stand there and strike out with every pitch thrown at you? Or are you going to hit the ball and keep going? I never had an option, because if anybody calls me, they know how my voice is on ends, the world is how it begins and ends. While in the hospital, I was watching a special on women's Tisdale, a very, you know, very special person that I hold dear to me. I actually got to talk to him before he passed. He said two things. He said, never give up. And quitting is not an option. No matter how dark it gets, no matter how weak you may be, until you take your last breath, you have to fight. And that's what I also learned here at USC. You have to fight on. You have to persevere. I don't care what the score is, you keep playing. And that's actually what I put in my life during the hardest time. She said, I challenge you to work on your legacy. Student athletes, we all have done a great job in performing at the highest level collegiately. For those of you who get to go on and, you know, create a bigger platform for yourself, I encourage you to realize that every given second somebody is watching you. And the greatest compliment you can ever get is that you are respectful, you are a great person. To say that nurse didn't change my life, I do not. I never thought about that because I was always a football player first and then everything else kind of trickled down the line. It's not till this day I can finally say that I'm proud of my legacy that I'm leaving behind for my family and my beautiful dog, Bailey. I thank you guys and I challenge you guys to work on your legacy if you guys already have started. I thank you for your time.